ओके बेटा, ओके। मेनी ऑफ यू हैज ज्वाइंड, यस। मोहम्मद हार्स हैज ज्वाइंड, आर्यन हैज ज्वाइंड, आकाश आकाश हैज ज्वाइंड। सो टुडे आई विल क्रिएट एन असाइनमेंट फॉर यू इन दिस वेकेशन, एंड दिस असाइनमेंट इज ओनली द एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चंस। डू द एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन in your notebook, class notebook, and submit it. Yes, beta, yes, I will mark your presence. Yes, Neela, I will mark your presence. Yes, beta, yes, yes, Minal. Your presence will be marked. Neha, yes, beta. Welcome you all once again in today's class. And let us start the questions of the exercise. Keep a science book with you and open the page number 193. Page number 193. Here are some questions. Prior to that, there are some activity-based question. Activity-based question. Good morning, beta. Good morning, all. And now some questions. In-text question. Page number 193. Question number one. Here is page number 193. Question number one. The answer of these questions, please write. You have to write in this vacation in your notebook and submit it. Take just earlier you have to be scanning and submitting. In that way, you have to submit. Question number one: how is our atmosphere different from the atmosphere of Venus and Mars? Our atmosphere is full of varieties. So many gases are there. Almost all the thing, everything is available in our atmosphere. What is the required for the life process? Oxygen is there, nitrogen is also there. So many other gases are there, which are necessary for the life process. So all the necessities of living organisms available in our atmosphere. While in Venus and Mars, carbon dioxide, mainly carbon dioxide is there. Okay, the main gas is carbon dioxide, and even moon. If you talk about moon, there is no atmosphere. Gravitational force is so weak that it can't hold any gas. Gas easily escape out from the moon surface. So there is no atmosphere on the moon. So Venus and Mars, the atmosphere is there, but basically carbon dioxide present in that atmosphere and some other gases also. Okay, beta. Question number two: how does the atmosphere act as a blanket? What is the role of blanket in this region, especially? It protect. The blanket protects the body heat to go outside. When we use this blanket, after some time we feel warm inside. What is the reason behind this? Whatever our body heat transmitted, this body heat is not going outside. It is remain inside the blanket and keep us warm. Blanket is not giving any heat to us. Simply, it prevents some difficulty. Recording is here. It is. Okay. So it prevents our body heat to go at outside. In that way, we feel warm after some time. That is the role of blanket. What is about atmosphere? We are getting heat from the sun. Sun is the source of heat. The heat is reaching to us in the form of radiations, light and some other radiations. Once the heat enters the atmosphere of the earth, it is being trapped by the earth's surface, by the air present in that, And during night time, yes, beta. Greenhouse gases, yes, very good. Greenhouse gases are there, moisture there, carbon dioxide is there, methane is there. Methane is also one of the greenhouse. So these gases trapping the heat released from the earth in night time or even in the daytime also. In this way, the earth atmosphere is remain warm even at night also. The much heat is not wasted, not lost during the night time. It is trapped by the greenhouse gases, moisture, carbon dioxide, methane. Okay, beta? So this is the role of atmosphere. It is blanket. It prevents Earth's heat to escape into the universe. It is remain trapped in the Earth's atmosphere. In this way, the temperature of the Earth is maintained. Question number 3. What causes winds? Wind blows. Sometimes we feel very strong storm. Storm we feel. And yes, beta. That is yes. Your attendance will be taken. Yes, I will take the screenshot of the screen and it will take. So you need not to worry about your attendance. It will be taken. I will take the screenshot. And it will be present mark. Your presence marks. Your presence will be marked. You need not to worry about that. It is my duty, and I have to do it. So tell me about this. What causes winds? Sometimes wind blowing, especially in this season. The wind is coming from northeast. From the northeast, the air is blowing, especially in this season. The reason? Variation in temperature and finally the pressure. Yes, better. North side, Himalayan area, temperature is too low. While away from that, temperature somewhat higher than that. That's why air is going upside where the temperature is high and creating some vacant space, sometime vacant space or vacuum like that. And to cover that area, the nearby air is rushing to that side, and the air is coming from the northeast to occupy that hot space where air is going upside and creating vacuum, creating low pressure. So because of the pressure difference, where the temperature is higher, pressure is slightly low, air is going upside, and to cover that area, wind is moving, air is moving from Himalayan side. That's why we generally feel the wind direction from northeast to this side. So the wind blowing or the cause of wind is temperature difference and finally the pressure difference. Temperature difference starts with that, and low temperature where pressure is normal, whereas high temperature air is going upside and creating low pressure. So it is the pressure, because of the pressure, temperature and pressure only, that causes the winds. Question number 4. How are clouds formed? We have seen a water cycle. Yes, beta. Droplets of air present in the atmosphere, after getting some nucleus like carbon particles, dust particles, these droplets are going to be bigger in size. Moisture reaching to the atmosphere due to the evaporation of water from the sea, from the lakes, from the ponds, from the fields also. Plants also releasing moisture into the air. And when the air and this moisture quantity is much enough and temperature is moderate, there is a dew temperature. Before that, there is no rain. So dew temperature, if it is maintained, then these water droplets going to be bigger. And for this, they need some nucleus. Nucleus like dust particles, some carbon particles. These particulates, they are working as nucleus. Some ions are also, I have told you earlier, it is also possible to go for artificial rain. If clouds are there, dew point which is needed, it is more than that, then clouds are unable to condense particles, water vapors are unable to condense, then the scientists, they are trying to spray some electrolytes. Electrolytes are some metals, some salts of the metals, they are sprayed in the atmosphere over the clouds with the help of a plane, and these electrolytes are divided into the positive and negative ions and working as nucleus. Around these particles, these ions, vapors are going to condense and they are going to be bigger and bigger, and finally they are starting coming down. It was practiced. Nowadays also it is in practice in some countries, not in our country because we don't suffer like that, but where there is a scarcity of rain, much scarcity, and they are able to do that because it is costly process, it is much costlier, so they are doing that. Even China, they are doing like that. Okay, better. So what how are the clouds formed? Due to evaporation and condensation in the atmosphere, that is the cloud formation. Question number 5, list any 3 human activities that you think would lead to our air pollution. Human activities, so many activities are there, we all familiar about that. These are, okay beta, exhaust of vehicle, yes it is correct, deforestation, industrialization, these are the main is transportation, transportation, industrialization, and in cities there is lots of constructions going on, concretes and so many other materials are used, cement is used, then dust going to the atmosphere, that is also going to pollute the air. Automobile is the main factor. In Delhi, near about 60% pollution is because of the vehicles, and remaining because of the factories, industries. That air pollution is because of the vehicle, main is transportation. Yes, better. Yes, yes. Now some countries, they are trying for electric vehicles and they are using it. They are going to plan up to this much year, after these many years they will be able to replace all the vehicles which are running today, they are replaced by the electric vehicles, and they are making the facilities of charging, some just like petrol pump, they are going to construct some charging points where the vehicle can be charged by the electricity. In our country also it is started, we are not far behind, we have also started about the electric vehicles, practices are going on. So you are able to list the at least three human activities, you are knowing more than that. One is vehicles, industries, even deforestation. Deforestation is also responsible for that, and these are the some reasons. Okay, these are the 5 questions. You have to write in your notebook and you have to submit it. When I create the assignment, then only some exercise. Here is some activity based question, you can read the activity and you can do. Page number, next page 194. Now come to the page number 194. Page number 194 now. Question number 1. Why do organism need water? What is the need of water? Why do we need water? Okay beta, no water, their bodies need water. Okay, why do organisms need water? Okay beta, yes sir. Okay, okay, Subhra, please answer this question. To keep our body hydrated, yes beta, Garvit. Transportation of various nutrients. The organism needs water to mainly transport the nutrients from digestive system to all body system, all body parts. It is the medium of transportation, medium of transportation of nutrients. Nutrients like whatever food we are taking, carbohydrate, proteins, vitamins, minerals. These are reaching to the various body parts through the blood. And blood is basically, it is the water solution. Our body is near about 70 to 80% water in our body. And this water is responsible to transport the nutrients to all body parts. So that's why the organism needs water for the transportation of food items, transportation of nutrients to the all body parts. In plants also, the transportation of a variety of nutrients absorbed by the roots reaching to the various part of the plant in the form of a solution, and water is the solvent for that. So it is the medium of transportation, transportation of the nutrients to the various body, various parts of the body. Okay, beta, is it clear? What is the major sources of fresh water in city, town, village, where you live? Major sources in our locality? Yes, beta. What is the major source of water in our locality? It is Chambal River. It is the dam. Okay, it is the river only. Here the dam is made. And water supply is made through the dam only. And in villages? In villages, what are the sources? They are making tube wells, they are fitting tube wells, ponds, and well, less better. These are the some sources. Canal is also there, lakes are there. Okay, these are the sources of water in villages. Okay, yes, beta. Good, good, good. You are well aware about these things. Many of us are living, coming from the villages. We are going every year to the villages and seeing their life, how they are living in that harsh climate. Situation is very adverse. Water scarcity is there. They are managing water and collecting water from other sources. So, tube wells is one of them. With the help of pumps, they are taking water outside, and this water is supplied to the various parts of the villages. Okay, beta. How do you know of any activity which may be polluting this water sources? What are the various sources of water pollution? Yes, beta. Industrial waste, yes, it is good. Gauravi, Gauranvi, yes, it is correct, beta. Industrial waste, and there is our vehicles are basically polluting air, atmosphere, water pollution. Talk about water pollution, fertilizers and pesticides. Farmers are using fertilizers in their fields. Sometimes excessive fertilizers, they are using excess, which is not needed actually. Washing cloths, yes, beta. Religious wastes, yes. Unknowingly, we are throwing flowers which were used for the particular purpose and other religious wastes in the water only. That should not be done. We are polluting water. We are creating some problems to ourselves only. So this type of thinking should not be there. We should not throw this waste, religious waste, into the water. We can throw some other places where it can be absorbed by the plants, like in fields. We can spread it. So instead of throwing these things in water, we have to check it. So the activities are, one is industrial waste. Nowadays, government giving permission to open the industries, which is somewhat away from the city. So that the industrial waste water, it should not mix with the normal other water. The sources should not be polluted. Factories, wastes, this is the main water source, pollution source. Even it is polluting groundwater too. Nowadays, government giving permission only those factories which are having well advanced water treatment plant. and they are regularly checking these water treatment plants. Even factory owners, they are also aware about that, because they are also facing the same problem. Groundwater, if groundwater is polluted, then from where they have to take the water for their purpose, industry purpose. So nowadays this care is being taken. Industries should be away from the city, main city. It should be outside, and there should be proper water treatment plant, so that there should not be any such water wastage which can create water pollution. Now, government giving permission to construct those buildings who are having water harvesting system. Without water harvesting system, no any organization is permit to construct a building or complex. So water harvesting is also one of the way to preserve water. So these so many activities we know which are responsible for the water pollution, and we have to check from our side also whatever we can do regarding prevention of the pollution, water pollution. We have to do minimization of soaps and detergents and other materials, other chemical, unwanted chemicals which is actually not needed. So that care we have to take. We can start from ourselves. Okay, beta. Next page. Page number 196. Come to the next page. Page number 196. 196 page. Question number one. How is soil formed? Soil. Formation of soil. What things are responsible for the soil formation, weathering of the weathering factor, which is one is a water. Water is also a major cause of soil formation. Water, air also is, winds. What is actually happening when water involves during rainy season, when the rain water is running through the stones, some smaller stones, they are also rushing to the ground, towards the earth surface, towards the ground, along with the water stream, and by rubbing process, by rubbing of the stones, they are going to be broken fine and fine. In this way, fine particles of the stones, they are reaching to the normal planes, and they are responsible for the soil formation. So plants are also responsible for the soil formation. They are giving so many wastages like leaves and branches. They are also going to be rotten, and they are forming. They are also responsible for the soil formation. They are mixing organic matters to the soil. Okay, beta. During winter season, when temperature is too low, whatever water trapped inside the stones, which where the cracks was formed due to the sunshine, due to different heating, some cracks develop over the rock surface, and water going to inside the rock through these cracks. And during winter season, when temperature is too low, the water is going to be freeze, and that's why it is expanding, and the cracks are going to be bigger and bigger. In this way, stones are broken due to this climatic change. It is not done in 1 or 2 years. It takes so many years. Repeatedly change in climates, the cracks are going to be bigger, and stones are mixing with water and going to the ground. Okay, beta. So sun is responsible, wind is responsible, and water is also responsible for the soil formation. These are the three main factors. Living organism, they are going to mix organic matters to the water. In that way, these all are the main factor for the soil formation. What is soil erosion? Yes, beta. What is soil erosion? The removal of topmost layer of the soil by the wind, by the rainwater, that is the soil erosion. Removal of the top layer of the earth. This can be done by the wind, storms. They are removing the top layer along with the high speed of air, and in that way soil erosion take place. Water is also one of the main cause of the soil erosion. That's why it is necessary to plant, necessary for the plantation. We have to do plantation, whatever possible, whatever you can do, we have to do that plantation and stopping deforestation. Roots of the plants, they hold the soil particles, and up to some extent, up to many extent, you can say it is responsible to stop the soil pollution. So the cause of soil pollution, what is soil erosion? Soil erosion, actually, soil erosion, that is the removal of the top layer. And what are the factors responsible for that? That is the air and the rainwater. Question number 3. What are the methods of preventing the reducing soil erosion? How to stop, how to prevent the soil erosion? Okay, beta, making barrier around the soil. Okay, very good. Planting trees, yes, beta, planting tree, actually roots, they are able to bind the soil particles, and up to larger extent they are responsible to check the soil erosion. So this by making some barriers in the rivers, dams like that, and small barriers in the small water bodies, there we have to make a small, even in the forest also, government from their side, they are making some small barriers to stop the soil erosion, and up to some extent they are able to stop the water also, and that in that way the water level of the ground is going to improve. So some small barriers, even they are digging some small ponds in some areas which can hold the water, and that way that water up to some extent it is going to be preserved in that area. So digging some small ponds are like that, they are able to stop the water, wastage of water, and it is going to reduce the soil pollution also, soil erosion also. Okay beta, now come to the next page. Next page is page number 201. What are the different states in which water is found during the water cycle? Different stages in which water is found during water cycle. Water from the water bodies going to liquid state into the one state, going to vaporize, vapor form, vapor is reaching to the atmosphere, going to make clouds, and cloud reaching to the ground. So liquid state, vapor state, and finally particles, that is the clouds states. So two states basically, liquid and gas, these are the two states of water. Name two biologically important compounds that contain both oxygen and nitrogen. Biologically important compounds which contain oxygen and nitrogen, yes, it is not E. Biologically important compounds that contain both oxygen and nitrogen, it is one of the protein. Protein is containing both DNA, RNA, amino acids. They are the compounds of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. Carbohydrates containing carbon or oxygen. Carbohydrate, nitrogen is not there. So we have to name such compound where where oxygen, nitrogen both present. One is the nucleic acid, yes, beta. Nucleic acids such as DNA, RNA, proteins, some vitamins, they are having both carbon and nitrogen. DNA, RNA, yes, beta, yes, yes. What is the full form of DNA? DNA, RNA, what is the full form? What are the main constituents of DNA? Full form, deoxyribonucleic acid. It contains carbohydrate, it contains phosphate and it contains bases, purines and pyrimidine bases, which contains nitrogen. This DNA, RNA, they contains S, beta, S, yes, you are correct, you are knowing well, DNA, RNA. So these are some constituents which are biologically important and containing nitrogen and oxygen, DNA, RNA, nucleic, that is proteins, amino acids, these are the, some main constituents, some vitamins also. Question number 3. List any 3 human activities which would lead to an increase in the carbon dioxide content of air. These are the general questions, Peter. Yes, you can answer this. Burning up the fuels, fossil fuels. Burning up the fossil fuels. This is the one human activity. Burning up the agricultural waste. Use of automobiles. Okay. So these are some human activities. Burning of agricultural waste. Now we are able to, we are knowing about this burning of paralysis in nearby states. It is one of the major problem. Deforestation is better, is Guarani deforestation is also one of the reason. So government is trying to avoid this type of burning process of agricultural waste. They are providing some chemicals and these chemicals are able to convert them, to degrade them within few days only into the manure, and it will be helpful to the farmers also. While burning, there is no anything, any use in their field, nutrition point of view, but creating lots of problem in air, air pollution. By using these chemicals, they are going to degrade these agricultural waste into the compost, and that is going to increase the fertility of the soil. Farmers are also going to be agreed about that. It takes some few days, but definitely it is useful. Government providing a free of cost, the chemicals provided by the government itself, without any cost. Simply they have to spray after completion of the harvesting period of the paddy crop basically. What is the greenhouse effect? Yes, we have studied about that greenhouse effect. That is the warming of the atmosphere, heating of the atmosphere due to trapping of reflected heat from the earth and the rising of atmospheric temperature. Yes, Peter. The gases are, one is methane, and there is carbon dioxide, and there is moisture. These are some gases responsible for the greenhouse effect. What are the 2 forms of oxygen found in atmosphere? Yes, Peter. 2 forms of oxygen found in atmosphere. Yes, name it. Ozone, very good, Peter. Yes, ozone. And there is, one is ozone, and there is O2. Yes. Many of you, yes, you all are knowing. 2 forms, one is O2 and there is O3. Dioxygen and ozone, these are the 2 different forms of oxygen in atmosphere. Yes, Peter, yes. You are knowing it. Now come to the exercise questions. What is the atmospheric essential? Why is the atmosphere essential for the life? It provides a different nutrient, oxygen, air, carbon dioxide for the life process. That's why atmosphere is essential. Why is water essential for life? We have discussed a lot. How our living organisms depend on the soil? They are getting nutrition from the soil only. Food items they are getting from the soil only. You have seen weather report on television and newspaper. How do you think we are also able to predict the weather by seeing the direction of the wind, climatic change and the moisture, humidity in the atmosphere? Up to some extent we can guess that today's day will be sunny or it is somewhat cloudy, that we can also guess. And by seeing the temperature, dew point, we can guess that whether rain is possible or not. Dew point is also necessary and it is available. What is the today's dew point as per the temperature? It is given by the, some informations are given by the newspaper and so many other ways. We know that many human activities lead to creating level of pollution of the air, water bodies and soil. Do you think that isolating these activities to a specific and limited area would help us to reducing the pollution. Yes, it is going to help a lot. If industries are settled in a particular locality, then the precaution can be taken that whatever water, waste water is released from that area, it should be properly treated. Nowadays, it is done in that way only in the cities. Some industrial areas are fixed. Only industry can develop in that area, not outside, not anywhere. So government is also doing in this way. They are deciding the place where this particular field is to be being constructed or being fixed, fitted. Industrial area is also there in the cities. Write a note on how forest influence the quality of our air, soil and water resources. Yes, forest is going to affect a lot in all these fields. Air, it releases carbon oxygen and absorb carbon dioxide, improving the air quality. In cities, you might have seen in Kota also, some oxy-zone, such type of area is located. Oxy-zone. Oxy-zone means what? That zone is allowed to the persons to walk, morning walk, evening walk, like that. No any other activities permitted in that area. That type of oxy-zone is also being developed in the cities. In Kota also, one oxy-zone is developed in the city, where only trees and some path are there where the person can walk. There is no vehicle permitted in that area. Only walking is permitted. So this is the, these are the questions. I will create a assignment for this homework assignment of this vacation, and you have to write in your notebook and submit it. Okay, beta? So thank you all. Thank you very much. And utilize this vacation period for your reading, for your various activity, various project activities, whatever pending work is there, please complete them. And thank you all, beta. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, beta. Thank you.